May I have your attention, ladies and gentlemen? Everything you review tonight has been pre-approved by the English department. Enjoy. A young girl with a strong imagination, but nowhere to direct it. Ruprecht, the character played by a marionette puppet, is mysteriously sent from another land to help Calabash direct her imagination towards dreams that really do come true. These dreams come true in a land analogous to heaven, which is where Ruprecht lives. Calabash must undergo the substitution of her old nose for a new one. While this process is symbolic of her regeneration, she must undergo her regeneration before she can enter the land that Ruprecht will show her. She must taste of the glories of this land so that when she returns home at the end of the play, she has something reliable to hope for. Throughout the adventures of Calabash, she craves a full understanding of the universe, but she must face up to her own humanity, which will not allow a full understanding. And so Calabash is on a spiritual journey through wonderlands of peculiarities, and Ruprecht is her guide. Tonight, you will see the first scene of my one-act play. To do the entire act would require a great deal of elaborate moving props, and professional magicianship. This, by the way, is my senior project. I wrote the script and the music, and I carved Ruprecht out of basswood at the Horsing Around Carving School, the same carving school that did the carousel in Coolidge Park. The element of puppetry in the play was inspired by my study abroad trip to Slovakia, where I saw a marionette show in Vienna and the street performers in Prague using marionettes. My idea to combine live actors and large puppets is not entirely new, because in Holland, in the 18th and 19th centuries, theater companies performed performed with both live actors and large puppets simultaneously. George Geisenbeck performed marionette shows juxtaposed with live-action comedy sequences. Around the same time, other puppeteers performed with 4-foot-tall, life-size puppets. And so, I guess you can say I'm attempting to bring back some old traditions. Tonight, I will be manipulating the puppet, dressed in black, and it is your job as the audience to use your willing suspensions of disbelief to pretend that I'm not really there. Calabash, the play, is somewhat avant-garde. And now it is time to prepare for the show.
Hear me and cast the gazes of their sparkling eyes about the room. This wondrous room where whatever I dream up finds a way to exist. Oh, damn the real world, for to live is to imagine and to spring to life is to dream. But so many times my room is lonely, and so many times my trinkets are only inanimate objects with drooping eyes. And so many times I ask myself, why do I give myself to this? Oh, wretched existence.
Social justice, avenues of heaven stir.
Spiritual nerd. nourishment.
Yes, she needs a lengthy excursion into the peculiar lands where I come from. A journey to the reality of fantasy. To see beyond herself and those pitiful representations that she collects. She must first visit my land in the afterlife before she can live to her full potential down here.
And it's my job to be her guide.
Colors of a universe vastly arrayed. Come here, sweet Calabash, and don the mystic sky. I've got many blessings to throw before your eyes. Come on, little Calabash, come and follow me. Now, now, now. I'll show you to a place where your heart can finally be free.
Thank you. die. Second of all, I thank the cast. And here are some other things. Becca Norman for the violin intro. Bonnie Pappas for lights and sound. Bud Ellis and the Horsing Around Carving School. Brian Walton for recording and music. Bill Turner in the carpentry shop for making the window prop, and Andrew Stewart for helping me paint it. John Balson for managing the curtain. John Porter for steering me towards puppetry. Chris Ammons for designing the 11 by 17 inch flyers and the playbills. Fernando as doorman. Ethan Pettit for loading out one of his marionettes and for creating the bell that you heard and for his expertise on puppetry. And then, of course, last but not least, my mother who sewed the Rubrex clothes.